that you are going to find out, pick out the oligopoly markets features. So let me give you the list out of oligopoly markets. First feature, we can say that there will be few number of sellers, few firms selling the same product, homogeneous product. And they are independent, interdependent. So if one firm is going to bring change anything in their product, so automatically the other one is also going to bring change to compete in the market. So that we can say that it is an interdependency. And there won't be any price competition among these firms. Only the differentiation of product competition will be there. And there will be barriers to enter into this markets. And selling costs will be playing very important role in this oligopoly markets. How it is going to play important role, that we will see in detail later. And they are going to behave as a group. And based on the nature of the product, the oligopoly market will be existing. And the demand in this case will be indeterminate. Indeterminate means you cannot say that how the demand curve will be changing. As we have seen in the elastic demand and inelastic demand, we cannot say that exactly in this manner only the demand curve will be moving. So how it will be, that we will see in detail now, one by one. So few firms means, as we have seen in the examples, only few firms are selling the same product now. So that we can say here, one of the feature. And you cannot exactly determine that only 10 firms are existing or only 5-6 companies are existing to frame an oligopoly markets. Like that, we cannot define exactly what is the number of firms that are existing in the oligopoly markets. So mostly in oligopoly markets, the companies which are in large companies, those who are going to be competing in this oligopoly markets. Small companies, even though they are existing, they cannot beat these big companies, no? So they will be following the larger companies. In what way they are behaving, accordingly, the small companies will follow. But mainly this oligopoly is related with the big companies, because they are going to hold the market. Large portion of the market will be holded by these oligopoly firms. And they will be producing the product. They will give importance to the total output. Because they are interdependent, they have to give importance to the output also. So these among these big companies only, there will be severe competition between them. So if one company is going to manipulate firm, the other one is also going to manipulate the prices. So whatever the changes the one firm is doing, the other large firms will also take in the same manner decisions related with that. Either it may be related with the prices, or it may be related with the quantity of output. Example you can take here, automobile industries, as we have seen in the previous examples. There are only few producers of automobiles, no? So if one firm is going to take any action regarding its product, so likely if any slight change it is going to bring in its product, automatically that will affect the other firms that are existing in the market. So automatically they will be like a rival firms. So always the rival firms will be watching at the other firms what are the activities they are doing, what are the changes they are bringing in their product. Always they will be keeping an eye on that companies. So which is holding a large share in the market. So the second feature comes interdependency. As we are saying that they are going to keep an eye on the other rival companies, no? So what are the actions that the most leading company is taking? So based on that, the remaining firms will be acting. So this indicates that they are the interdependence firms. Because if one firm is going to bring change, means bring change in the product's quality or whatever, or output or price, so automatically, immediately, the rival firms will be reacting accordingly. They will also act according to that changes. So this reaction you may expect in this oligopoly markets. So more interdependency will be there among the firms. So the example you can give, for example, cars are there. Some few firms are going to dominate this car industry, you know, automotives like Maruti, Tata, Hyundai, etc. So if, for example, if Tata is going to bring change in the in its vehicle, say for example, Indica, they introduced into the market, automatically the Maruti, Hyundai, etc., all these companies are going to bring new products into the market. So like that, they will be bringing changes in the products, which we can say that it is an interdependency. Next feature comes this non-price competition. Non-price competition means what? The prices, if there is any change in the price, war will be there among these competitors. So to avoid that price competition, they will not bring change in the policies of prices. Instead of that, to compete in the market, they will be bringing change in the product's quality or features. And they will bring change in the demand and supply, so that automatically they can attract the customers. So for that, most of these oligopoly markets will be advertising more. They will concentrate more on advertising instead of concentrating on bringing change in the prices. And they will also provide better services than the competitors to attract the customers. So like this, they will compete with each other. So advertising and providing services will make the customers to attract to that company product. You know? So that manner, and by that, they can compete with the rival companies. So instead of raising their price, this is how the companies are going to hold the market. And the next feature comes barriers to entry of firms. Mainly in this oligopoly markets, to enter the new firms, there will be certain restrictions will be there. So even legally, there will be restriction to enter into the market. Getting patents, it will be very difficult. No? If patent rights are there automatically, that product cannot be produced by some other. Features cannot be produced by some other firms. So like this, if any patents are there, or if the large quantity of capital is required, because to produce cars, it is not an easy task. No, they need more investment. So, which all the small firms or new firms cannot be able to afford it. So, if it is not affordable, the companies cannot enter. No, so such barriers will be there to enter the new firms into these industries. into this oligopoly markets, due to which oligopoly market is existing. If these reasons are not there, we cannot prevent the new firms to enter into the market, which will not create this oligopoly market. So automatically, if oligopoly market is there, abnormal profits will be earned by the firms which are existing in the market. Abnormal means more profits they are going to earn. The next feature comes role of selling costs. As we said, they are, instead of bringing change in the prices, because they are interdependent companies, so they need to compulsory use the techniques of sales promotion. So various sales promotion techniques they have to use to promote their products in the market to attract the customers. So which will lead to selling cost, to incur the selling cost by the companies. So many times they have to advertise about their, continuously they will be advertising about their product frequently. So which will incur the selling cost by the companies. So as this is given more important in case of oligopoly markets. So which is also important for monopolistic competition. And the next feature comes to the group behavior. So what is a group behavior here? Because the companies are oligopoly firms are interdependent, they are behaving according to the behavior of the rival companies, no? So that means they are influencing the other companies. So that means one company is behaving in one manner, the other are also going to behave in the same manner. So which we can say that it is a group behavior of all the few firms which are existing in the market. So instead of having their independent prices, they are going to play certain strategies, bringing change in their product. So this will lead to be an group behavior. Sometimes they will come to an decision that everyone should take the same, they have to act in the same manner. If they are few, they will be protecting their profits or protecting their customers. To exist, both a few companies come to an understanding that let us behave in the same manner instead of taking as an rivalry. So like that, if they are going to come to a decision, that we can say that it is a group behavior. So every company will be following the same instructions instead of individually competing. And the nature of the product is also going to be the important role in this oligopoly market. So nature of the product means here all the firms will be producing here same product, homogeneous product, but they are going to differentiate slightly from one from the other, like a cement or steel or whatever the industry you are going to take, that comes under this oligopoly market. Same homogeneous product, cement and the different cements, there won't be any different cements. No? So only they are going to differentiate it by saying that strength is there in my cement, like that some advertisement they are going to do. No? So like that, they are going to differentiate their product. So this is some of the products which by nature, we cannot differentiate them more than the competitors. So to differentiate automobile industry like this, you can take. If you want to differentiate from one company to the other company, this automobile industries can be taken in as an example. So which we can say that imperfect oligopoly market will be there. In case of cement, steel, we cannot bring any differentiation of the product, no? So they are homogeneous products. So which we can say that, which we can call it as pure oligopoly market. So in determined demand curve, we are saying, so this is one of the feature of oligopoly. You cannot determine what is the demand of the product, how the demand of maybe. So due to which we can say that the demand is uncertain. Because the firms are interdependent, we cannot ignore such uncertain demand, because the rival companies will be acting in one way, means. So automatically the demand for our product may be shifted to that rivalry company. So any change in the price of any one company may lead to automatically reduce the demand of the product. So in this manner, immediately there will be, that means within a short time, there will be effect on the demand of the product. So which we can say that it is an indetermined demand. So all these are the features which are going to be making that a market as an oligopoly market. So that's all the features. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me.